Hey everyone, it's Demetri from Softr, and in this video, we're gonna dive into action buttons. We're gonna talk about all the different ways that they've been updated, and we're gonna talk about how to edit records, do one-click update, delete records, and how overall visibility works from a page, block, and button standpoint. Let's dive right into it. So I'm gonna go into a new application here, and let's go into this employee directory example. So first, let's dive into the different type of action buttons that exist. Right here, what we have is nothing from an action button standpoint. There's nothing on this list block here. And if we wanted to add some, it's pretty easy to do. But say we only wanted certain types of users to have these different abilities. What we can do from a visibility standpoint is layered on three different levels. First, we have page visibility. So as you can see, I am on the engineering department detail space. So for example, if I go here and press the three dots and then settings, you'll see there's the option for visibility. Now, right here, what I have selected is logged in users. So there are a couple different ways that you can, in any circumstance, limit the visibility of something. In this circumstance, you need to be signed in order to see this page. Now, if I press non-logged in users, then that would limit it to that set. If I press all users, then it doesn't matter whether you're logged in or not, you can see this page. And then with custom user groups, you can also do a different layer of that by saying the only user group that can see this is managers. But that's not the only level of visibility that you can set. For example, if I click on this and I were to go to the action section, you'll see that there are a couple different types of buttons here. There are top bar buttons and then item buttons. Top bar buttons, as you can see right here, are open page, scroll to, open URL, and add record. If I press add record here, what this essentially does is give us the opportunity to add a new member to this engineering team. So you could say add new team member, and then you can change the text here to add new team member. New team member added successfully. But what you'll notice here is if I click on this little button visibility section here, we have the ability to change it to all users, logged in users, or non-logged in users, which is the exact same functionality you have when you click on the block itself. And then you can see right here that there's a section for visibility. So we have all users, logged in users, and non-logged in users. You even have the ability to limit the device accessibility based on what you click here. However, it does need to be visible at least one device. You're also able to change it from a custom user group standpoint as well at the block level. And like I said at the beginning, it starts at page level as the top level, then block level, then button level. And this is the case for not only these top bar buttons, but also, for example, here with the item buttons. So as you'll see here, there are a few different options. You do not have the top bar option of add record, but instead what you have is edit record and delete record. So in this section here, what you're essentially able to do is say add new team member and then map the different fields. So you can see here, it has the name, and then we can figure out what the rest of the fields are here very easily by going to the content section. So in the item fields, it's showing when I click on it, what the exact field is that all of these different items on this are. So then if you were to example, want to have the option for only logged in users or a specific user group like managers to add these people here, you can do that. So if I were to be logged in and look at the view here, I'd be able to see this add record. And obviously, as mentioned previously, there are different buttons that you can use here. So we have the item buttons, and the edit record button is one of the unique ones that you can use here, as well as the delete button. So we can add this update record here, and then also we can add a delete record here. I think a really obvious use case is very similar to this add record one. We could set it so that if you are, for example, a specific user group and you're a manager, then you're able to change this. But if you're not, we wouldn't want somebody who's like not a manager just go in and be like, yeah, I'm gonna delete everyone in the department like that. That would obviously cause problems. We really don't want that. Is that what you want? That's not what I want. So by having it set like this, we can clearly have it here, but for the edit record, which is an update, it essentially allows you to batch update the different fields within here. So for example, say somebody would want to update their different fields here. Say they changed where they live, for example. We can go and publish this, and we'll see in our data set here that, for example, Danny Coronado is an employee. Now I'm logged in as Danny, and I want to go to departments here. And then I'm going to go to the engineering section. And you'll notice what's really interesting is I don't see the add or the delete options. Good. Because if I did, I mean, that'd be a little uncomfortable. We don't want to add or delete if we're not a manager, as mentioned. So if I'm logged in as someone in engineering now, in this case, I'm logged in as Cameron Toth, I can press update record and say, for example, Cameron got promoted. I can update it to senior software engineer and press update. And if for any reason, anything else needed to change, whether it be his location or his title again, or even if he had a nickname and wanted to add it in there, he can update it. But in the manager standpoint, based on how we have the button set up, if I'm logged in as Robbie Pritchett, I can see two different buttons now based on the visibility filters I set. So I can see the delete button and I can see the add record button. Now we do need to configure this. So the form needs to be configured. However, the delete button's pretty simple. I just press delete and then it says, hey, you sure you wanna do that? Like, you really wanna delete this? Are you sure about that? You're not gonna get it back. So don't delete it unless you're gonna know this is what you want. Like, are you gonna delete yourself, Robbie? Is that what you really wanna do? So in order to set that up, we can very easily go back into our department detail page, go to the actions section, and in the add record, we would very similarly add the different fields that are needed. So for example, what I like to do when building apps is take a screenshot or split screen, or use my cool double monitor setup to look at what I have for edit record and for add record. So I'm gonna take a quick screenshot here and then map these out. So same order would be if we pick a file and then do photo, then name, job title, employee type, and location, and make sure that they're the same field type. And I like to put in the placeholders as well. We would put in a text field for name, make sure that these are required as well. Then job title, then a dropdown for employee type, and another dropdown for, we type location, then put in location at the bottom here and make sure it is required. Then once we press publish updates, we'll see that now Robbie Pritchett as the manager is able to add a record here. So when a new team member comes in, manager can come in and be like, I got a new team member. They're welcome to the party, guys. But overall, action buttons, visibility, edit buttons, delete buttons, all of these things are really great to help you with visibility and additions to and edits of your business information. And even better, they're able to help you make sure that only the right people have the right access to certain actions. With that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. And if you're interested in learning more about Softr, make sure to check out everything else at our YouTube channel. Thank you, and we'll see you in the next one.